We're living on a blue planet, so a planet that 97% of water is salty. 2% of that water is frozen, which is leaving 1% of water that's available, of which agriculture is using 0.7% of that remaining 1%. So agriculture has a huge part to play in the sustainable use of water. And recently the World Economic Forum has identified water as a major global risk. We have 884 million people without access to drinking water. We have almost 2.5 billion people without access to sanitation. 20% of the world's population is living in water-stressed regions. And we're facing a future whereby we're going to have to find enough water to grow the crops that will feed 9 billion people by 2050. So we need to find a route to help us navigate a course to feed 9 billion people, deliver a sustainable business for Olam, and not impact on the water needs of anybody else. In the face of sector challenges, Olam has pledged to deliver inclusive water management across its value chains. And we'll do this by improving the resilience of our operations, increasing productivity, whilst enhancing water availability and usage with the farmers in the communities which we work in. In response to these challenges, Olam has developed a four-step strategy. First step is about increasing water use efficiency from agricultural operations and from our own processing and manufacturing operations. And we've done this in a variety of ways through the development of hybrid onion seed technology by our US operations. We've been able to reduce the amount of water needed to grow those onions by 7 million cubic meters over the last 4 years. The second step is about minimizing the impact of wastewater in our agricultural operations and our processing and manufacturing operations. In the agricultural operations, we build what's called a buffer zone, an area between where we operate and the watercourses that are nearby. Now, this reduces the effect of chemicals running off into the river. So things like fertilizer when it rains could run off and pollute the river, but the buffer zone will allow that to be reduced to safe levels. Our third step is to improve water-related health in Olam's workplaces and ultimately in its supply chains and in the communities in which we work. We have an Olam standard that's been implemented across the business to focus on water, access, sanitation and hygiene. Our fourth step is about how to collaborate for long-term, equitable access and use of water. An example is our coffee operation in Tanzania. Here they've identified all of the water users, both upstream and downstream of our own operation, and brought them together to form a water users association so everybody has a voice on how water is used in that region. They've taken the Water Users Association to the Tanzanian government and had this recognised under Tanzanian law. So the community now has a voice for how water is managed in that region. I believe Olam is truly leading in several areas of work with regards to water. I also believe we're one of the leading companies with regards to collaboration on the subject of water. We're a member of the UN CEO Water Mandate. The aim of the mandate is to mobilise business leaders to address global water challenges through corporate water stewardship. A great example of this is how we've worked with the Alliance for Water Stewardship to road test their standard, which will hopefully become the global standard for how water needs to be addressed going forward. If we're going to truly deliver a sustainable approach to water, then it's going to require real collaborative effort. And that means business, it means the farming communities, it also means government. And only by all of those stakeholders working together will we be able to work at a suitable level that's going to deliver a sustainable approach to water management.